Hey, it's Christina with Kapwing, and I've got a tutorial on how to add audio waveforms to podcast clips. We'll be using Kapwing. It's a free online browser-based editing software. Let's get started. I'm going to go through it twice. First time, it'll be nice and quick, and the second time, I will give you a few more tips and pointers and some style advice. So if you click on the link in the description, you will be taken here. It's the Waveform landing page. You'll see a bunch of different examples of different ways and styles you can make your piece. And then click Get Started. Import your audio, and that's it. It's literally so easy. You just bring your file in, and then it automatically happens. And then once you're here, you can make a few different choices. You can stylize it like that or like this. Over on the side, there's different options. You can change the color. You can trim your video by clicking the trim tool, and then you can cut out certain chunks you don't want. Anything that's red, you're going to be cutting out. You can also go into the timeline and cut out bits of your audio. I will go into more detail on that in the second version. You'll have all of the conventional tools that the Kapwing Studio offers. So if you click on the upper left corner, upload, you can bring in footage, you can add text, you can search Google for images, you can add subtitles, that's super, super helpful. You can add elements like squares and boxes and different colors. So now I'm going to show you a bit more about those tools and how to integrate and make your piece look cohesive. Here's another example I mocked up to show you how to add audio waveforms if you've already started editing your piece. If you look over here on the side, you'll see all of your layers. You can click on them, click out into this gray area to unselect. So we want to select this one that says podcast, VC podcast, or Vicious Cycle podcast. And when you click on the audio layer, you'll notice this, all these options appear on the side. If you click convert to waveform, and then it'll just appear. That's all you have to do. And then, you know, you still have the same options of shrinking it and changing the colors. You can use this color picker to get your exact color palette to match your logo. It's pretty cool. So here is a mock-up I made. It's not a real podcast, but it's one that I think should exist. I think my dad would be adorable reviewing Costco wines because it's like one of his favorite things. How did I do this? I started with a design, and then I clicked upload up here on the left to bring my audio in, and then I edited the audio in the timeline feature. Click on the bottom right at the timeline button. These things you can kind of ignore. These are just the style shapes and text that I added. But down here, this is our audio layer with me speaking, and then right, this sound wave audio layer is the background music. So the music was kind of loud. So if you click on the music layer and then go back into studio, you can, over here on the right, you can control the volume. And then I went back into my timeline, and I didn't have to make any cuts in this version, but you can, if you move your player ahead, this little bar here, over a section so you wanted to cut it out, you click the split button, and then you can drag a clip so you can take out a chunk. You can reorder pieces too, so you actually have a lot of ability to edit within here, which is super convenient. If you're a creator and you want more tools to express yourself, subscribe to our YouTube channel because we have tons of great tutorials.